how using BCC reduces spam. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. BCC is one of those tools and technologies that some people just don't quite get, don't understand exactly how it works. I'll dive into that a little bit. But one of the most important things it does is it actually helps reduce the amount of spam on the internet. Here's the question. Is it true that if I use BCC to email attachments, it will mean less danger of spam? How's that? Well, to be clear for the question, BCC has nothing to do with attachments. They are two completely separate things. There's just no relationship between the two. On the other hand, using BCC on messages you send, it's not going to reduce the amount of spam you get necessarily, but it's going to reduce the amount of spam that could potentially be generated because of your email. Let's look at a couple of examples. So I'll show you exactly why this is. I term this a privacy violation because if you take a look at the example, there's a message that you got that is from a friend of yours. It's to you, and it is CC'd to, in this case, four or five other people. And it's basically just an example of a forwarded joke. So what's happened here? Your friend has emailed you a joke, and of course, you think it's funny, that's great. But the point is that at the same time, your friend has exposed the email addresses of everyone else he sent that message to. Now, that may not be a problem. It may not seem like much, but not everybody wants their email address exposed to everybody else, especially not to people they don't know. So you've now got these six or five other email addresses. If you wanted to, you could harvest them. You could put them in your address book. You could send email to them. You could do whatever you wanted to, all because your friend included their email addresses as CCs or twos even in an email he sent to you. It gets worse because this is where you become complicit. If you now forward that message because you thought it was a funny joke and you want to share it with some of your friends, you forward it to somebody and somebody else and somebody else and somebody else. In the example here, you know, you're forwarding it to a close friend, a family member, a pal, a colleague. Point being that you've also used either to or CC, and whoever gets this message can now see all of the other email addresses that you sent to. But they can also see the email addresses your friend included originally. So not only are you exposing the email addresses of your friends and colleagues that you're forwarding the message onto, you're also exposing the email addresses of everybody else who originally got the email at the same time you did. That, as I think of it, is what I would call a privacy violation. You have exposed a bunch of email addresses of other people who might not want their email address exposed to a bunch of people that they probably don't know. Now, of course, we trust all our friends, right? We wouldn't send this on to somebody that we wouldn't trust. But you're assuming, for one thing, that their email will never be compromised. You're also assuming that their email isn't archived somewhere. And you're assuming that that email, that message, isn't going to be accessible to malware, to scammers, to spammers, to people who are basically looking for email addresses every time they connect to the internet. That's a lot of assumptions. All it really takes is one person to do it wrong and everything gets exposed. You can be a good email citizen by doing exactly two things. One, instead of entering all the email addresses on the to or CC line, use the BCC, the blind carbon copy line, instead. That way, those email addresses will not appear in the email that you forward. They'll still get it. There'll still be recipients, but their email addresses won't be visible. And second, before you press send, click on the body of your email message and delete all of those other email addresses from the body that were included in the email you received. A lot of people don't realize this, but when you forward a message, if you click in the body, sometimes you have to click on little three-dot ellipses to expand the body, but the bottom line is that it's there for you to edit, and you can edit it however you want. And one of the most useful things you can do is to delete all of those other email addresses from the body, and in the case of a joke, delete everything that isn't the joke, right? So that then protects everybody else from having their email address exposed. That's all you had to do. BCC and delete everything other than what you really intended to forward from the message itself. So here's what that looks like, right? When we go to forward that mail, in this case, it's from you, you send it to you. In other words, you're sending an email to yourself. A lot of email programs require that you have something in the to line. When we're doing this, it's usually most useful to just send it to yourself. There is no CC line, but everybody that you want to send this to, everybody that you want to forward this message to, is in the BCC line. And then if you take a look, the body no longer has email addresses in it at all. All it has in this example is the joke. What the recipients see then is from you to you and the joke. That's it. Not only are you not exposing all these other email addresses, but you're making it easier for the message to be read, right? You're removing all this clutter that otherwise other people would be looking at. So please consider using BCC when you're forwarding, especially to a large number of people, and consider editing the body of the message that you're about to forward to remove any potentially privacy violating information. I hope that's helpful. I hope you take it on. If you've got questions or comments, or if you want to see related links and more, visit askleo.com/11797. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.